everyone, Ian here, and behind me is a 2006 Meridian 459 that's located here in San Diego, California. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this yacht has to offer.
All right, so here we are looking at Saint Independence, the 2006 Meridian 459 that's here in San Diego, California. This particular vessel really has a lot of outdoor living space. A lot of people love it just for how open and bright it is. And one thing that you're gonna notice here in just a second is just some of its remarkable design features that just accommodate a really good time out on the water with a great flow. Large swim platform here on the back of the boat. We have the swim step ladder that comes out of this section right here. Nice little storage area right on the swim platform that's built in. As we walk in through the aft deck access, below us here are two large hatches. We have the generator down here, a little bit additional storage. Off to the starboard side, this lifts up right here, and we have storage underneath here, water inlet. We have this really nice opening glass door that gets us right down to the master stateroom, and that's what people love about this boat, is just how the flow of this vessel just really opens up. I mean, you can look at this aft master cabin and just see the accessibility of that is quite nice. This is just like coming out to your back patio. On the port side of the vessel, we have really nice gradual steps with stainless steel handles on both sides that get us up to this second aft patio here. The aft patio is quite nice. We have the overhead hardtop. We have connections for canvas. There are no side enclosure canvas panels for this, but that can easily be installed. Two plexiglass doors that can close off so you can keep people from going up forward and or just, you know, keep that wind diversion down if people are back here. Side loading, you know, access doors here, both to starboard and port side. Nice wide side decks with stainless steel grab handles, allowing us to give, you know, get easy access up to the foredeck. Here on the foredeck is a really nice section here. You can have cockpit cushions if so desired. There's cup holders, stainless steel handrails here. We have access to the large Lumar windlass with up and down foot switches here. And then also you can see down into the anchor locker. It is kept very, very clean. Spotlight here as well too. This will give you a nice perspective looking aft. As we make our way around the foredeck back into the second aft cockpit, you can see here this nice perspective of the upper flybridge. There's our second opening door here for accessibility out to the dock if so desired. But there is a nice large bench seat off here, a table. Just forward of that is additional storage. We have sink, kind of a glove box area up there. Access down into the salon, but then let's walk up to the flybridge. The flybridge has this huge L-shaped seating here off to the starboard side, a bench seat off to the port side. Underneath this is additional storage. And then as we come to the helm itself, we have this nice pivoting seat here. We have the Raymarine E80. Plotter. This also has integration with radar as well too. North Star depth, Raymarine ST 6002 autopilot. We have a JBL stereo controllers. These are our shift controllers. Our wheel just forward of that is our instrumentation for both diesel engines. We have our controller here for the stern and bow thruster. The bow thruster is out, but everything is set up and with proper diagnosis, you can get the vessel's stern thruster to be back up and operational. Throttle controls here, and then all of our switching from our up and down windlass, bilge pumps, nav lights, trim tabs, that's all set up here. But really nice lounge seat here. And as I mentioned, the seating and just the flow of this is quite nice. Taking you back aft, I want to show you the upper hard top here. We have our GPS antenna, our radar, and our VHF wand there. So give you a nice perspective looking down on the two back patios here. And again, just the flow of this is so remarkable. All right, as we come down below into the salon, we have a sliding glass companionway door that opens up. There are three steps coming down into the salon. The carpets were just cleaned. Off to the port side is this large bench seat here, a large couch, and kind of looking up and around, you can just see, again, the popularity of this boat with all of these, you know, opening hatches and large windows that just really flood this area with a lot of natural light. Looking at the companionway steps that we just came down, below here is our engine room access. I can pull this up really quick. And again, you can see the engines are absolutely taken care of in really great condition here. And beautiful engine room. The owner's done a phenomenal job there. And then as we walk up to this cabinet, we have, you know, battery switches, controllers, a little bit of shelving here. This is our main breaker systems for 12 volt 110. And then again, you look at the touches with the woodwork, the Corian countertops, flat screen television. There's also two heating air conditioning controllers here in the salon, the JVC DVD player. And then just forward of this is this really nice dinette. So the dinette itself kind of up forward midships off to the starboard side, and really a great place for just, you know, entertaining and dining. And then we have a drop down galley. So it's only two steps going into the galley. Again, when you look at all of the finishings and the countertops and the sinks, it's they've done a really nice job here. Stainless steel sink. We do have a little wood discoloration under this, but not a big deal. Lots of storage here. Great countertop space. Just underneath this large Corian, you know, kind of lid is a three burner electric stovetop. And then again, we have drawers and storage everywhere here in this galley. Large refrigerator, and above that is the freezer. We also have a Samsung convection microwave oven here. And yeah, just beautiful wood floors. Directly across from us is the forward day head and VIP cabin head access here. We have a full walk-in shower sink with a vacuum flush toilet. So I like that it has its accessibility here for guests. And then as we move up to the V-berth, you can see a really nice centerline, a queen berth that's just really a great design too, because they didn't taper it, so they kept it straight, you know, just like a traditional mattress. So it's comfortable. There's easy access both up to starboard and port side as well too, to climb into bed, to make the bed. Big large locker there. Three opening hatches in this stateroom make it really nice and just airy. Additional hanging locker off to the starboard side, and then again your own access here to the shower head compartment, and then that door will close off. It also has its own separate air conditioning heating controls here as well too. But again, all of the vinyl, all of the walls overhead for this age of vessel is in really good condition. All right, let's walk up forward and aft, and I will now take you down into the very aft master stateroom. So the aft master stateroom has two steps that take you down here, and we have this very large, you know, kind of centerline berth here. Lots of opening closet space, shelving. We have additional shelving with kind of like a bed stand next to each side of the bed with Corian. There's 110 outlets, 12 volt outlets, and all your lighting switches. Again, when you look at all of the vinyl material, all this is in really good condition. Nice mattress, your own heating and air conditioning controls as well too. And then looking off to the port side, you have this great mirror here, sink, vanity. And then behind this door is a separate shower compartment. So built-in seat here, really nice fixtures, opening hatch as well too, to note. And then behind this is our vacuum flush toilet. So this is a separate from the shower, which is quite nice. You have your own lighting switches, great countertop space, additional storage, opening hatch as well. And then again, the claim to fame for this particular model, not only all the light, the brightness, the air, the storage, but look at this. Coming two steps and now we're into the aft lower deck, really enjoying our view. If we're out in Catalina, you know, on a mooring right now, this would just be phenomenal. I can see some patio furniture back here. And again, great accessibility and great exterior living space. That concludes the video walkthrough for the 2006 Meridian 459. I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you like it, please give it a thumbs up. If you would like more information, please feel free to call me, text me at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business.